The patient emission prediction tool is a tool to look at exactly what it says. It predicts to about 95% accuracy which patients are coming in and when. We know today that there are 12 people coming in with broken arms and legs. Only one of them's coming up to date, but we know there's another 11 out there. So what we've been able to do is set aside emergency theatre time for these people already. So we know that they're coming and we know we can treat them.
The moment I walked in, I spoke to the person and I sat there for 10 minutes and the doctor called me in and see, here I am. So it was like less than half an hour and I'm waiting to have my cast put on.
It was difficult at first because many people didn't believe the tool could do what we said it could do. Up to recently, a fallacy existed that all hospitals had to be at 85% occupancy for optimal patient flow. Using the mathematics of CSIRO, we've actually dispelled that rumour and we can actually show categorically that that's not true. And we've actually worked out optimal occupancies for not just our hospital but other hospitals. Now people trust in the tool and it actually informs our strategy. The performance of this hospital compared to the data from 2010 has actually increased its 4-hour score by 20%. We now run above the federal target and we're one of the largest HHSs that actually is able to do that. The impact for staff is that this can be done within hours, so that it actually minimises the amount of overtime. It also minimises the amount of stress because it's done in a well-ordered fashion and everyone knows their jobs and responsibility and where the actual problems that we need to address are. One of the key points with the partnership with CSIRO is that we provide the clinical input. The mathematics, resource optimization, etc. does come from the CSIRO expertise, but it's marrying these two important areas together. You couldn't do it without either one, and that's where the partnership has been fantastic. The proof of the pudding really of this tool is we're in the middle of winter. It's the worst point for an emergency department because of the winter surge that occurs. Up to recently, you would have seen pictures of ambulances queuing outside to get into emergency and all the beds being full. If we look today, on one of our busiest winter's day, you can see there are still 3 beds in the emergency department and there's only 1 ambulance outside which has managed to offload its stretcher. What we were able to do with this tool is show people that actually what happens in healthcare is very predictable on a day-by-day basis.